Diva, so your girl's back with a new hair tutorial video. I do apologize if I sound a little bit raspy. So as you guys can see, this hair is braided up and the ends are left loose. It's just to make life much easier for me. I decided to use this 50 volume developer, which I've never used before. I don't really try to go past 30, but hey. Also, this pristine light, and this is the blue label, so that way, you know, because it's dark hair. So I'm not really sure how you pronounce this company, but they are available on Amazon, and I think it's called Calais or Calais Hair. I'm not really sure, but you guys know I will get to chopping up a name. So I decided I wanted to just do something different, and life sometimes gets really hard when you're doing all these different colors, plus the hair starts getting away. So I was like sitting and thinking, how am I going to make this so much easier for me to actually process, like bleach? So I decided to just braid the hair and just leave the portion hair that I want to bleach in color unbraided, which makes life so much easier. So that is the reason why I decided to do this. Now, I didn't want to have a mess all over the place. So yes, you guys, this is like really, really like, okay, ratchet. I'm using the back of my mirror because I just wanted to make life easier. And then I was like, oh my God, April, you don't even use aluminum foil. So how are you going to process the ends? So what did the girl do? I went downstairs in my kitchen and got some sandwich baggies and wrapped some rubber bands around them because I do like to use plastic on my hair. But normally it's just like an entire bag because the entire hair is bleached. But this time I decided to use some baggies because I only wanted the ends to be processed. And the plastic also does hold heat, which also helps with the processing method. Girl, let me tell you, this process was so much easier than I've ever done it before. I think I'm gonna try this for like an ongoing thing. But the 50 developer works so fast, like it lifts the hair up so quickly. Now, like I was saying, I'm not really sure how to pronounce the name of the hair company, but like I said, I'm hoping that I'm saying it correctly, and it's Calais Hair. They are available on Amazon, so listen, if you guys got Prime, you can definitely get you like some really quick shipping. You guys know I'm always talking about Amazon, how like they got the best stuff. But the hair quality is really good. It's their Brazilian Virgin Straight. They did send me 4 bundles, an 18, 16, 16, a 14, and a 12-inch closure. I ended up only using 3 because, you know, I just didn't need all that hair. I was trying to put it all on the unit, but I think like the 3 bundles was more than enough. Okay, so as I was saying, the 50 developer is the first time for me using this, and it does process really quick. The hair did hold up really well, and I was surprised because I honestly thought this hair was going to be smoking. So this is how they look once I'm done. You know, they're all like little baggies. You guys can see it's kind of like processing through the plastic, and this is what it looked like, you know, after a while. Like, this is how light it got. Now keep in mind, it does get lighter than this, but you know, being that I have the plastic on it and it still has the, you know, mixture in it, it does look a little bit kind of like on the funky side, but it actually did come out really, really like a blonde color. So unfortunately I didn't show you the dyeing process, but it's the same dye I used before, which was the Revlon. What's up, love? So now it's time for part 2 of this video. As you guys seen, I did bleach the hair, and I thought it was a lot easier to do it the way I had, which was kind of like sectioned it off. I did use the 50 developer and it worked really good. It did process it really fast and it didn't dry the hair out, but you know, it kind of looked a little bit brassy to me, and I really did want to just color it. I loved the color that I just did, which was the bright auburn, just using the Revlon color silk box, which is really inexpensive. It's $2.92 at your local Walmart, but I went ahead and I purchased another box of it, so I went ahead and did this unit as well. I totally forgot to take the dye off. I think the dye was sitting on the hair for like 3 hours. I really forgot about it. I went upstairs, I started editing a video, I was on the phone, and then I realized like probably like after three and a half hours, amazingly, the hair was still you know, still intact. I did deep condition it for like 2.5 hours, just because the only thing, it did dry a little bit at the ends, but that's what a lot of hair, I noticed, like when you process hair and bleach it, it just gets dry at the ends. I also did bleach the knots in the unit just because I wanted just a little bit more of a realistic part. I wanted just to do it without like makeup, you know what I'm saying, all of that makeup and stuff. I just wanted to do it without all of that. But in the end, I'll probably still put like a little bit of pressed powder in the cap because it just makes me feel a whole lot better about the unit. I just feel like it looks more natural. It does have the combs in it like normal. I do have my 1.5 inch barrel, which I do use, and this is available at Irresistible Me. I love this wand barrel set. It comes with 8 different interchangeable barrels, and it's like really life. Like, seriously, it's life. I do have this here, which is the Silk Elements Mega Silk. This is just for heat, so you get to protect the hair from heat. But it also has olive oil in it, which is great. So I do use this on a lot of my units, especially if I'm processing them. I'm not really sure how you say the name Kalai. I'm not really sure, but it is the Brazilian straight. And it's 18, 16, and 16 inches. I didn't use the 14 inch because there was more than enough, and then I used the 12 inch closure. So probably looks a little bit choppy right now because this is the actual closure right here, but for the most part it did come out really nice. It is still a little bit damp in some areas, but we're gonna go ahead and style this and see how it came out. I'm gonna take this, which is my pressed powder. Alright, you guys, so this is the finished look. So for this unit, it is kind of probably short for some people. It's just like average length. It's 3 bundles and a closure. I did like the way it came out. I just think it has a little bit too much body. Like, you know, when you first curl something, the curls just be like extra tight. The color came out nice. I think it's a little bit lighter than the first unit that I made, which was all totally bright on auburn. But for this one, I didn't want to go for that particular look. I just wanted it to be like ombre. And plus, I did bleach this hair a lot lighter. I used the 50 developer and I bleached it twice. One time I did bleach it off camera, and yeah, that was about it. But the hair did hold up. Like I said, the ends did get a little bit dry. Nothing that, you know, some scissors can't help, or, you know, you could deep condition it. But so I'll definitely post their information below. They do have an Amazon store that you can visit. And I hope you guys enjoyed this long tutorial. Make sure you rate, comment, subscribe, thumbs this video up because you love me. Share with all of your social media friends and family. And on that note, I love you guys as well, and I'll see you in a soon to come video.